एवरीवन, टुडे वी आर डिस्कसिंग अबाउट द ब्लॉक डायग्राम ऑफ कंप्यूटर्स मींस कंपोनेंट्स ऑफ अ कंप्यूटर. दिस इज़ वेरी इंपॉर्टेंट क्वेश्चन. श्योरली दिस क्वेश्चन पेपर सो मेनी टाइम्स कम्स इन क्वेश्चन पेपर ऑन क्वेश्चन पेपर फॉर 10 मार्क्स. देर आर 5 फंडामेंटल कंपोनेंट्स ऑफ अ कंप्यूटर सिस्टम. विल सी वन बाय वन. सी हियर, इनपुट यूनिट, मेमोरी यूनिट, अरिथमेटिक एंड लॉजिकल यूनिट, कंट्रोल यूनिट एंड आउटपुट यूनिट. दीज आर 5 फंडामेंटल components. See, this is a block diagram of a computer system. Input unit, MU means memory unit. This is output unit. This is ALU means arithmetic and logical unit. CU means control unit. And both ALU and CU is called as a CPU. This is whole, we can call it as a CPU, central processing unit. Here arrows represents bus or connectors. We use arrows for to transfer data from one unit to another. Bus means what? It is an electrical roadway along which all signals are sent and all functional components are connected. There are two types of bus. This is one way and two way. This is both sides arrow are here. Here is one side arrow. One way bus and two way bus. One way bus we can call it as a one way bus is unidirectional bus, and this is bidirectional bus. See here, arrows represents bus or connectors used to transfer data from one direction to another. Bus, it is defined as an electrical roadway along which all signals are sent and all functional units connect to an roadway. Means using arrows we can connect the one unit to the another unit. There are two types, unidirectional bus or one way, bidirectional bus or two way. Two way means both sides arrow. One way means this is only data can transfer from one unit to another unit. It doesn't come back. Here the data transfer from one side to another side, again it comes from that side to this side. So this is a two way. Then first unit is input unit. First we'll see input means what. Input means it accepts data from the user, that is called as a input. Data can be converted into computer acceptable form. Means computer understood only the binary formats. Means 0 and 1, these are the binary numbers. Computer doesn't understood the English like language, means A, B, C, D. If I have written some anything in English, otherwise they have given some calculations, numbers, then the computer doesn't understood that. That numbers can convert it into these binary formats. Some examples, these are the input units, keyboard, mouse, scanner, joystick, mic, light pen. These are input units. Then second one is memory unit. The main feature of a computer system is its large storage capacity, which is called as a memory unit. Then it has a large storage capacity, means we can store the large amount of data in this, that is we can call it as a memory. Memory unit is used to store data, instructions, fully or partially processed information. Means we can save, store data temporary also, we can store data for permanent also here. There are two types of memory, that is primary memory and secondary memory. These are two types of a memory. Memory unit is made up of number of memory locations. We can store the data in location. There are some location, in each location it has some number. In that we can store the data. See here, each memory location has a location number called as a memory address number. We can call that locations is called as memory address number MAN. In that location we store the information. Then third one is arithmetic and logic unit. Arithmetic and logic unit is the brain of the computer where actual calculations are performed. Why we can call it as the brain of the computer? If I have given some instruction, means data to the computer for calculating. See, for example, I have given some mathematical formula, means addition of two numbers. then it is saved into the primary memory. Then when it is calculating that time, the data goes to ALU for calculations. Means actual mathematical means addition, addition, subtraction, multiplication, division. These are the arithmetic operations that is calculated actually in ALU. So ALU is called as the brain of the computer. Then second one is data instruction that are stored in primary memory are transferred to ALU. See, I have given some data to the computer that is first saved into primary memory. When it is calculating, that time it goes to the ALU for calculation. Then arithmetic operations. Arithmetic operations are addition, subtraction, multiplication, division. These are arithmetic operations. And logical operations are greater than, equals to, less than. These are logical operations. Hardware components available in ALU. There are some components, hardware components are in ALU. First one is accumulator. It holds the result of the arithmetic and logical operations. Means whatever data we have given or whatever calculation is calculated in this, it holds the result. That is called as an accumulator. Then general purpose register. It is used to store the intermediate results, operands and some other general computational data required during arithmetic and logical operations. Third one is counters. They are used to perform up and down count operation used for simple counting operations. See, if you want to, if you have given some data for calculations, these counters can calculate in that data, means processing that data. Then fourth one is shift registers, used to left shift or right shift the binary data. If you want to shift the data to right side or left side, we use this shift registers. Then adder, it is used for logical additions. Then comparator, it is a circuit used to compare two numbers, means how we comparing two numbers. For example, one number is greater than the other number, means we comparing the numbers here. This is greater than, less than, or less than, equals to, greater than or equals to, less than or equals to. These all are comparators. Then arithmetic operators are addition, subtraction, multiplication, division. And logical operators are and, or, not. These are logical conditions. Then fourth one is control unit. CU means control unit. The control unit decides the sequence of operation to be performed. Means this unit can decide which operation should perform first. That is the work of this control unit. It also coordinates the flow and execution of data and instruction that are supplied into memory. Means it can coordinate all the components of the computer system. Means that all components are working properly or no. That is the work of this control unit. It controls the all components of the computer system. It does not perform any processing task but controls and coordinates all the units of the system. There are two types of control units, hardware control unit and microprogrammed control unit. These are two types of a control unit. Means this control unit can control on the hardware also and programmed. Means programmed control, microprogrammed also. Then functions of control unit. There are some functions of a control unit. First one is input management. Input management means what? To make the input unit work to get the data or instructions. Means whatever data we have given for computer, whatever data we have given to computer for processing, it will accept. That is the function of the control unit. Means it is accepting that data. Memory management, to get the data from storage unit to ALU to perform processing. What is the work of memory management? Means whatever data we have given for calculation to computer, it will accept through input management and it is stored into primary memory. Then when the actual calculation is happening, that time that data, primary data is transferred to ALU for processing. That is the use of the memory management. Then output management. to display appropriate final result through output device. Means after accepting, it is stored into primary memory. When it is calculating, it goes to the ALU for calculation. After calculation, means we get the result. To holding that result, and it this output management can display that appropriate result on monitor, means through output device it will display on the monitor screen, means user can easily see that result. Then CPU control unit management. CPU means central processing unit to coordinate all the activities of the computer system, that is the work of the CPU. Then fifth one is output unit. This unit supplies information or result to the outside world using output device. What is the use of this? Means whatever calculation is calculated, that result is displayed on the monitor screen through output device. That is the work of the output unit. The result generated by computer are in coded form, which is not in human acceptable form, because computer doesn't understood the English like language. Means whatever numbers, English means ABCD, whatever alphabets we have given, that is not understood. Computer doesn't understood. Computer understood only the binary format, means zeros and ones. Then whatever data we have given, that is converted into binary format, means computer can understood, find out the result and gives the displays the result on the monitor screen. But that binary format result human cannot understood. So again that calculated result is converted into the human acceptable form. That is the work of the output unit. See here, output unit convert this into human acceptable form or readable form, means English like language. That is again it is converted into the English like language, means human can easily understood that result. For example, these all are the output units: monitor, printer, speaker, plotter, LCD means liquid crystal display, video means visual display unit. These all are output devices. Then CPU. CPU means central processing unit. It is the heart of the computer and it contains two main units called as the ALU and CU. The main task of CPU is, why we can call it as this is a heart of the computer, means actual calculation is, this is the combination of the ALU and CU is called as a CPU, and ALU is called as a brain of the brain of the computer. Why we can call it as a brain of the computer? Because actual mathematical calculations happen in ALU, so we can call it as the brain of the computer. So the main task of CPU is, first one is fetch the instruction. Fetching the instruction means taking the input. It fetch or task the information or data stored in the memory. Means a user can give the data to the computer for calculation. Means whatever data we have given, computer it will fetch and it is stored into memory. That is the fetch the instruction. Then decode the instruction. Decode the instruction means instruction that are fetched. Means whatever data we have given, it can fetch the data and stored into memory, that is converted into, decoded into computer acceptable form. Because whatever data we have given, computer doesn't understood. So it is converted into binary format, means computer can understood that language. Then third one is execute the instruction. After instructions are decoded, the computer understood the operations to be carried out and acts accordingly. This process is called as the execution of an instruction. After converting that data into binary format, computer can process the result, means it can calculate the result, that whatever execute that result after the instructions, means that is whatever result he can find out, it will displayed on the monitor screen through output device. Then monitor screen is one of the output device, means human easily can read that see that result on the monitor screen. Then bits. Bits means what? The numbers 1s and 0 of the binary number system are called as a bits. Means 0 and 1 are the binary digits. Then conversion. Remember this conversion. This is very important. Sometimes this binary conversion comes for 2 marks. 1 nibble equals to 4 bits. 1 byte equals to 8 bits. 1024 bytes means 1 KB means kilobytes. 1024 kilobytes equals to 1 MB means 1 megabyte. 1024 megabytes means 1 GB, 1 gigabyte. 1024 gigabytes is equals to 1 TB means 1 terabyte. These are the conversions. This type of question comes for 2 marks. Then we will see the characteristics of computers in next video.